Evening, folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Planet Zoo, welcome back to the Mexican Conservation Park, and welcome back to my bongo. You all get a nice up-close look at my bongo there. And the baby bongo, baby. Let's take a look at... No, that's a rock. There we go. Look at the baby. Sukute! Adorable. Actually, painfully. Oh, he's so happy. Actually having the time of his life. Anyways, in today's video, we're going to click this button here because people are stressed, but that's fine. We don't care about that. Do we care about this? Yes, let's get a mechanic over there. Should be automatic, but it's not. Lots and lots and lots of research done. Good stuff. Okay, so what are we doing today? Well, we're working on our silver mission, and we're actually very, very close. Like, it doesn't necessarily look like it, but spending 3,000 on marketing is super easy. There you go.
Happy faces of all these guests gives me a really warm feeling inside. Oh, no, wait. Wait, that's actually my habanero taco kicking in.
Pew, pew, pew. There you go. That's 3,000 a year. That should be that done as well. A little bit more research finished. This is good. This is what I wanted. Is this my Arctic? No, it's my Indian. We already did the Arctic. Let's do... Oh, you know what we need? As people mentioned, thank you very much for mentioning this. We actually need to make the whole park eco-friendly eventually. So we are actually going to need wind turbines and solar panels and stuff. So we should get those researched. Now, that's a lot of... Saga, Shelter, Kingcrutch, Dinosaur, Tobias Rost, Vechandler, Jordan, Frenzy, Banny0080. Lots of lovely people in my park. Anyways, silver. So that done. I think it'll actually have to go through the year for that to pop up. We need 4 habitat species from the tundra biome. So that's really what we're working on now for our silver mission, is our tundra animals. Now, the only one we're not doing is the polar bear, because the polar bear is already coming into the park. So that's not one we're going to be going for. I think Arctic wolf is going to be gone for. I think the doll sheep we already have. We need 2 more. Does grizzly bear count as tundra? I have to double check that. Maybe grizzly bear? Polar bear we can't do. Reindeer for sure, actually. That's 3. That's at least 2. I actually don't see a 4. let me have a little look here. Why am I struggling with the basics of the alphabet here? There we go. People are fuming, aren't they? Tundra? Yeah, so grizzly bear's on the list as well. Oh. You know what? Stop being stupid. You're fine. Stop your whinging. Okay, so what I really want to do is like a tundra section. I want you to walk into this whole new part of the park, and it's very tundra themed. I think we might do it over here. This bit's already got like a bonus exhibit, so I think it makes sense to extend somewhere else. Who lives in there? That's the elephants. Elephants are well known. Oh, he's having a sit down. Elephants are a well known tundra animal, so we're gonna roll with that. Is it this? It is indeed. Right. So we need to thicken this bad boy up. I think it's an 8. Is it a 7? It's a 7. So I'm not really sure what we're doing here. I'd like you to walk forward and just have a little something here, because I think we should have like a tundra section in some ways, right? So tundra themed stuff, otherwise it's going to look a little bit odd. I don't want to go like over the top with it, but I do want to have a little bit of fun first. Can I duplicate these? No. I want to steal some building. I think I can steal this one for some reason. Yeah, weird that that's like that. But what we can do is grab like that there, maybe. And bring it over here and use this as the entranceway. Because it's on theme, it's on point, and it does kind of have a little bit of a tundra theme to it. So we're going to flip that way, I think. Try to get that nice and central. About there, bring that bad boy up. Let me have a little look down here. About there. There we go. Is that a group? Nope. I just wanted something so that when you're walking along, you feel like you're entering a new section to an extent. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what I also want to do is grab the... what are these? What they've been using over here? Architecture columns. We can do that. I'm just going to assume all my animals are okay. I know that's like slightly blasphemous, but they do tend to be okay. Something like that. Okay, and duplicate that. Shift you off to the... Oh. Duplicate, maybe. Right. I hate when it does this. Okay, we can figure this out. This is fine. This is fine. This is fine. Eh? What are we aiming for? That corner there. Okay. This is the price we pay for on-point themed parks. And let's do the same again. Let's try to drag it up to these ends over here. I don't know how we're going to make this tundra themed necessarily without it looking a little bit weird because we are, you know, there's loads of sand around and blah, 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 blah. But we're going to give it a good go. We're going to try. Oopsie daisy. I'm tempted to just full on make like an ice palace kind of shebang, but we'll see. Oh, wow. I did that. Oh, this bit's higher up. Yeah, that's me being stupid. Never mind. Grab that there. Come on. There we go. Grab that there. I think all these could move a little bit over that way. There we go. Lovely stuff. Okay, so we need, like, text. Are we all finding it? Yeah, they're just getting stressed every now and again. It's really not that big. It sounds like a big deal, but it's genuinely not right. What I want to do is get rid of this bush here. Ruining my aesthetic. And I want to duplicate this. Oop. Just this lamppost. Match it up with that. I didn't really think I'd ever be doing stuff like this on campaign, but here we go. How do I make this feel tundra-esque is the main question. Because if we're adding three more tundra animals, we may as well make it like a little themed area, right? I'm just going to get some text. Alpha. Alpha? Just typing my own name in there. We're looking for... Yeah, we're gonna just write like tundra zone on like the front here. Now, I want to point something out which has been bugging me since essentially the game came out. So it's going pretty well here. Just clicking the letters. And if you want the D... which we'll brush over that one. You have to scroll back to the top because for some reason the alphabet starts off small and then the big alphabet is in the middle, as you can see. Like this here is the big alphabet. And so that's little d, big D. And then you go down here and it goes little again. It's actually insanely annoying. I don't know why it's in the game, but it needs fixing. Fun story about that. Not fun story, but a childish story when we were in... when I was doing my biomedical science degree. Don't mind to say it like that. When I was doing biomed back at university. We were doing... I can't remember what it was exactly. It was something to do with... I really cannot, off the top of my head, remember what we were doing. But it was something wherein there were several forms, and whether it had a capital D or a lowercase d would sort of denote which form that came in. I think it was a hormone or something, but I really, it's been, you know, 8 years or something. Anyways, so it meant our lecturer, this bizarre little woman, had to say big D, little D about 5,000 times in the lecture. And bearing in mind, we're like teenagers at this point in time. It was just the funniest thing at the time. It really was. Looking back, it was very childish, but it was still funny. Just hearing your lecturer say big D constantly. Ah, they were the days. I miss university. Anyways, I want to colour this in. Let's get a little bit of blue. That's what we need to do. Get some theming on the go. This looks weird. So this tree is ruining everything. I want to keep the tree, but I don't want it there. Let's move it over. What is this? What is this? Why is there... What looks to be an arboreal feeding platform or something. I'm thinking... which I know sounds dangerous, that we just kind of, you walk through here and then it's just the plants change, the path changes, everything just changes. We'll just go over the top of it, you know, why not? Live the dream. It may end up looking a little bit bizarre, but I don't know, I'm pretty down for that. I think we'll go for the wooden path. More than, I think, because that'll blend in a little bit, this one's going to look extra weird. So you walk through and say probably from about there instead. You start to, you're in the tundra zone now, boys and girls. Yeah, 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 why not? Okay, so, I really do want to get the first animal in today, so let's go have a little look. I'm feeling wolfy. Who else is feeling wolfy? Are we all feeling wolfy today? You should be able to organize by biome, that'd be really cool. Or reindeer. We've got a male and a female. Let's go reindeer. Eino and Haymo, they are amazing reindeer names. very glad that we picked these up. And we'll just send it to Reindeer just so we can... I'm confused. What am I confused by? Why can't I see Reindeer? Honestly, there's something like a basic comprehension of the alphabet sometimes gets me. Like, why can't I can't see Reindeer? Right, no, I'm not being stupid. Reindeer's not there. Why is it not on the list? Oh, it's at the bottom. I forgot they did this. I really hope they undo that at some point, but hey-ho. Okay, that'll do for now. So I think you want some Reindeer nice there at the start. So let's give it a go. Basically, let's put in the barrier. Let's do a null barrier to kick things off. I'm thinking I can join it onto this, and it should... Oh, that's a little bit iffy. What I might do is actually raise the terrain up here and just make that more of a clearer boundary. That looks better. There we go. Right, so, okay, back to work. I'm going to stick with, I think... So I want this to feel like its own section to an extent, but I also do still kind of want it to feel like the rest of the park. So we're going to stick to roughly the same materials, which means wood and brick. Which both have a kind of Arctic feel to them anyway, right? Oh, okay. Alright, who doesn't want to be wood? You want to be wood. You want to be wood. So, oh, somebody over here. Ah, right, it's just because this is immensely high. If we do that. No? Okay, interesting. You're fine. You're fine. You're fine. You're not fine. Are you fine? Right, I think this bit's probably too close to the path. Let's just bring that in. Bring that straight down. Delete that. And bring that across to... There. Okay, good stuff. So, the rest should, in theory, now work. What is going on? Will you just... Oh, aw. What's up, buddy? You're in the box for some reason. Let's get you unboxed. Ah, right, we've got overcrowding on our warthogs. That's fine. Let's find... Is there a male somewhere I can get rid of? Yep. Sorry, buddy. Away you go. I actually need the conservation points anyway. Do I have more male warthogs? Oh my god. There's too much going on. I think I'm probably going to put more coolers in the doll sheep as well, just to stop it happening more than anything else. Warthogs. I only want one adult male. Like I said, we might want those points for something later on. Okay, so, how are we going to make this look less terrible than it currently does? Oops. Bring that up. Like so. Kind of liked that, actually. Like, a little part of me was tempted. You know what? Yeah. no, but also, yeah. Actually, see, that's so tempting to me for some reason. I just think that looks really cool. Looks better than... Because this is very, like... I don't know. Yeah, it looks cool. Anyways, but we'll leave it like that. Right, so we need to bring these fences down because it's bloody insane. And we're going to keep them quite low in general just because it's a reindeer, right? I don't think the reindeer... The reindeer jump in this? Are the reindeer liable to do a little runner on me? Are you at the bottom as well? No, you're not. Why are you at the bottom? Whatever. 1.25 meters is all we need. Okay, so that's not a problem. At the moment, we're at 4, so... We do have to be careful because it is going to be multiple heights across the whole thing. But we can come way down. We really can to like there. And then grab this bit. Oopsie daisy. Okay, that's weird, but that's fine. Grab that bad boy. It's just a slightly awkward exhibit because of all the different sizes. Like every single panel is a different size than the previous panel, basically. It's kind of a pain in the ass. But we can fix that. See, that one is now actually too low. We're getting there, folks. We're getting there. Don't worry about it. I'm not really sure of a neat way to do this. I think we just need to kind of do that. Whew, that's close. Something like that. I think that's okay. I'm going to change these middle ones just over the river to mesh. Okay. It's going to look cool. It doesn't look cool yet, but it will look cool. It's huge, isn't it? This is way bigger than it has to be. Right, so this is going to be our little staff entrance. Oh, I'm inside you. Okay, this is going to be our little staff entrance over here. We use the wooden ramps, okay. Okay, nope. So what you do, this is a common problem people have. You just delete this fence here, and you rebuild it. Now you have to rebuild it as its own thing. So you have to start from there and go across, and then join in. If you do that, then it works fine. As you can see, top tip. This is the only top tip I have, and I've said it like 5 times now. But it is my top tip. Let's bring that way down and connect that onto there. Like so. Alright, just calm down, lads. Calm. You're not low welfare. No matter how many times you tell me you're low welfare, I'm not going to believe you. Okay, let's get those into the zoo. For some reason, this mass clicking and putting your animals into zoo is only doable in campaign. I can't do it in franchise mode. Let's get Oliki and Bolted to join our zoo as well. It's all kicking off, isn't it? You two. What is going on here? You're complaining about temperature. You're complaining about stress. I don't even know why. Nobody can see you. You're literally completely out of view from everyone. I think what you need to do in this situation, just add a few plants around. They do actually block. Oh, no, 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 no. No inbreeding. Oh, I just had inbred babies. What is going on? Everyone's going mental. I'm just going to ignore it. Oh, excuse me. We're going to need a staff section over here. Now, we're going to need some coolers. It's actually insane. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Right, coolers everywhere. I want them to cover the entire bloody thing. You will not be able to go anywhere in this exhibit without being cooled. Okay, are we happy? I think we're going to be happy. Okay. Let's speed up time, get these coolers cooled down, and then we'll try to make the reindeer moderately happier than they will be, because they're not going to be filled right now. There we go. Pause. Right. Reindeer friends, what do you need for terrain? Oddly enough, pretty happy. But, I want to bring the snow in. I think it's going to look weird, but if we're going to commit to doing like a tundra section in our park, then we're going to have some snow. What I might do to make it look a little bit more realistic is to put the glass roof over each exhibit as well. I just think that looks pretty cool, actually. Oh, have you not cooled down enough? There we go. Look at that bad boy. I think it's cool. It looks bizarre in the context of the whole thing, but if we make the glass kind of extend over there, or we give each one like a glass dome above it, then maybe it'll kind of work in some ways. I don't bloody know. We're going to see what we can do. So, you need some hard shelter, don't we all? Right, let's have a look what we can do for reindeer. Who? No, no, it hasn't. No, it hasn't. I'm not worried about that. I guarantee that's a Gemsbok or something. Yeah, it is. Not a problem. Okay. I thought I got the Arctic. Oh, I did get... you know what the problem is? Like, Ewok Village. Oh, that was from my video. I did get the Arctic pack, but... I didn't get the things for it. Well, I'm going to keep that one going, but I'm going to get back onto the Arctic theme. Just so we can get some of these blueprints. Then again, won't they be in shelters? Isn't there a thing for that? Am I crazy? Habitats. Okay, you know what? Let's go on that one as well. Aza Slaughter. What an amazing name. I'm going to wait on the shelter. Let's do some plant coverage. So, Nature! We need biomes, tundra and taiga. Continent, North America, Europe. We'll do a little mix, don't see why not. And yeah, we good? All right, let's see what we can do. Black spruces, love me some black spruces, I'm telling you. Block off this right-hand side a little bit, block off the, do a little forest over here maybe. A little one over there. Got anything else? I want to mix and match the colours a little bit more than that. Get it. Oh, no, no, that's no, that's probably not what I was aiming for. There we go. Little baby one? Nope, you're not a baby, you're a big boy. Little baby over there. Big boy over there. Okay. And I'm so tempted by the festive spruce. I'm going to put one cheeky festive spruce in, okay? Just one. Because I will get addicted and put 5,000 in them. In there if I'm given the opportunity. I'm going to try to resist. Also, yellow cedar. This is precisely like building the Timberwolf habitat in our franchise playthrough. Exactly the same selection of trees, essentially. There we go. Kind of fits, right? If you ignore the desert behind them and stuff like that. Also, you've got some... Ooh. I'm tempted to go for more like, nah, I've already established the themage here. I'm also tempted to maybe put some ivy along this. You know, it is going to look like the rest of the park in some ways, but I'd like it to have this kind of, I don't know, style that the rest doesn't. It should feel similar, but different. Does that make any sense at all? I think it does. Like, it should be a recognizable part of the park, but you should also feel like you've entered like a new world kind of thing. I really don't like this alpine stuff. If there's one problem with the alpine, it's the plant selection is awful. Don't get me wrong, that makes sense. I'm not taking issue with that inherently, but... it does make life a little bit harder. One broken tree, a little bit there. The Scots pines were here back in the day, but unfortunately they did not survive the winter. Which doesn't maybe make sense, but that's okay as well. Don't like lady ferns. Oh, Labrador tea though. Labrador tea is my faves. I actually adore Labrador tea so much. It's a strange sentence. Look, if you're going to make tea, why not use a Labrador? I used to have a Labrador called Paris. Because oddly enough, we bought her on the way... Him? Her? I actually can't remember. On the way back from Paris, as it happens. We were very original. Like, we had a dog, a Springer Spaniel called Casper. Guess what we saw at the cinema that day? The only problem I have here... Oh, white, my beloved white sage. I was about to say I don't have access to my favourite bushes, and then white sage pops up, making me incredibly happy. Now, we are building on snow, so I don't really want to go too far with this, but I do think it still makes sense to have foliage, right? Like, there are some hardy plants out there that would survive these kind of temperatures. For sure. Including my beloved white sage. Now, whether white sage would be one of them, I actually don't know. I don't know much about white sage. I might try to learn about white sage before the next video to educate you all on my... I say favourite plant. I actually think it got reduced to my second favourite, but it's up there either way. God, I love white sage. they don't have my other favourite, do they? They do! Diamond leaf willow! Oh my god, I love this stuff. Okay, we're going to save this because I want this for the rocks. It's just diamond leaf willow and white sage together. Just make grass. They really do. It's awesome. Okay, I'm going to stop there. That's actually enough ground coverage. Right. Rocks. Now, I've been thinking about this. I think I do want to do like an ice flow kind of thing on the water. So... ice. Is that going to work? Yeah. Sorry. I'm just, yeah, like, I want there to be, like, this kind of stuff. I think it looks really cool. And then I think we'll use the, maybe use the snow rocks up on here and put some foliage around them. I don't know if this actually looks good, but we're going to roll with it anyway. I do want to stick to the thin rocks. I don't want it to feel like there's a massive iceberg, you know. I just want it to feel like shards of ice that I've broken off. See, that's too big. It's a thick boy. I'm looking for thin boys and girls. I'm down for curvy ice in general, but not right now. That one I actually really like, but it is a thick boy as well. Is that okay? Screw it. One big chunk of... Oh, no, they've ruined... I want them to float. They need to be floaters. All of them need to be floaters. So, there's actually a limited amount of shapes I can use, so we're going to have to jam them together, basically, to get what we want. It looks a little bit odd, if we're honest. That's okay. A little bit strange. I just want, like, a big, weirdly shaped piece of ice. That's all I'm looking for here. I don't really have that. Yeah, I don't know, I'm pretty okay with that. It's near enough what I was looking for. And then I want to set it up so it looks like this could feasibly be cooled to this level. And then maybe hit the river and it stops. Each thing, each exhibit should feel like this own little microcosm, you know? I'm going to change this to glass as well. Maybe one-way glass? I don't see why not. Do I have one-way glass? Well, that would be a good reason why not, I guess. Okay, so, and these need to be... brick. Looks a little bit odd, but I kind of like it. These like little mini windows we've got going on. Yeah, I don't hate that. Do need to go through and do this for absolutely all of these, because that's the established theme, and I'm not willing to move away from it. I do think I might skip forward this part, folks. Out of sheer love and respect for all of you at home. Oh, this is actually too small. That needs to go up. Out of sheer love and respect, I think I'll skip this part, because I can't imagine it's going to be that exciting. Okay, took no time at all, but I very, very quickly brought in, basically copy and pasted this, if I'm totally honest. I don't think you can really notice. And I actually think it really sells the idea I was going for, because covering this up and putting the... Not only did the shadows and stuff look pretty cool, but I think just bringing this in makes the idea seem more feasible somehow. It just... Because it feels enclosed a little bit, it feels like it's more realistic for you to be able to control the temperature in the way that I'm talking about. Now, whether it's the appropriate size to be able to do that or anything like that is a whole other kettle of fish. But the point is, it kind of feels that way, you know, a little bit. At least for me, anyway. I get that impression. What I'm considering as well is bringing up just the back wall way higher. Even higher. Even higher. Kind of so it matches with the bottom of the thing, actually. I don't know if I like that or not. I like the idea of having a wall. I'm going to build the wall. I'm going to trump it, basically. But I'm not sure on that. I'm not sure on this pillar. I think it looks pretty cool. The forest is kind of sitting on its own thing. I can maybe do some trees over here as well. Just because that area is looking a little bit bland. Kind of maybe want to block off the view of some of these pillars a little bit. More like that, yeah. Pleasant, I would describe that as pleasant. Okay, so. Everyone gonna roll with that. I'm tempted to mix it up even further, but I think we're gonna keep doing this. I'd like to just keep stealing this glass, really, and... doing my own thing with it. I also want to do like a little staff section. Can I just copy and paste you horse? Like this whole thing? Maybe? Oh, maybe. I know this is kind of cheating, but I'm okay with it. Look, it just works. Like, at the end of the day, we're trying to maintain the theme. Why build it myself? That's silly. Right, so yeah, I mean, this has basically everything we need. We're going to rotate, we're going to drag you down. Where's the floor? Okay, now all we need to do is connect the quarantine back. That's all. I'm a quarantine away from greatness here. Yeah, that took way more effort than it ever should have. But there we go, staff section done. Bingo bango. Bloody Nora. Right. Let's finish off with these reindeer. How are we feeling, reindeer? We good? 63, why so low? Hard shelter. I'm just gonna wait on the shelter because I want to bring in one of the Arctic ones. So I'm gonna give them some enrichment in the meantime, i.e., some skills. go. And they need a bowling ball. We need water pipe. And we need a barrel feeder. And we should be good. There we go. A 99%, not bad. They've even got hard shelter. They aren't registered, but this whole thing, of course, counts as hard shelter, because of course it does. So that's really cool. Yeah, we have no power over here. So where's my little doohickey I made? Yeah, this. Let's grab these. It's not our group. Okay. No. Don't think I can claim that's my own blueprint, unfortunately. Huh. Okay, weird. Huh. Okay, whatever. It's fine. So we need power over here. I'm really surprised that's working. I'm a little worried about the water one, and whether it should clip that over there. Let's grab that one as well. Come on, where are we? Okay, so I was a little worried about this path, whether that's gonna work. I'm not convinced at the moment, but we shall see. Oh, come on, I'm so close. You can do it, I know you can. I believe in you so much, game. You know what? It'll do for now. It'll be fine for now. What's the worst that can happen, eh? Let's not go there. What's that? What is that? I know what that is. It's weird. I don't like it. Where's the power thing? I was just... no. Yeah. Where's the bloody power thing? I was just stealing from it. Where have I put it? Oh, it's over here. Okay, we should be able to grab both of these. Really weird that I can't do that. Oh well. Okay, so we just need to grab these over here. Need to put these over the top. And then we have power and we're looking good. I mean, always look good, but... forward a bit? Yeah, I'd say forward a little bit. Duplicate. Move across. So as soon as I can connect that up, we're fine. Okay, it's cool. We have power. We have clean water. We need some facility thingamajiggies. I really like this. This is really cool. I built this myself. Like, I know it's nothing special, but it blends in, more importantly, than everything else. It actually blends in with the park. This less so, but that's okay as well. Just gonna... Oh, God. You're very awkwardly angled. I think that's okay, actually. One on that one, and have one on that one. We'll get funky with it. You know, I've always been a funky kind of person. Cough. Reindeer and reindeer. I'm tempted to put snow absolutely everywhere. You know, as you walk into the tundra zone, it's just snow constantly, and we'll just cover it in coolers and stuff like that. I'm still debating that. Oh, I need more rocks. I forgot. Well, I need snow rocks. There we go. Yee. Look at these bad boys. Are they great? I've actually not played around with these in an actual exhibit yet, so I'm quite excited to mess around with this stuff a little bit more. Looks really cool. It really does. And it blends in so well with the existing snow that you can kind of just dot them along, and it just brings a little bit of interest to the ground texture. Yeah, I love it. Love it. You can even bring in some normal rocks, I think, along with them. Ooh, I like that. I'm gonna have to stop before I can feel myself thinking, oh, I really like these. Maybe why don't we have like 10,000 of them then? Because that's too many, best in slot. 10,000 would be too many. I'll probably do. And then what we can do is grab a little bit more of my beloved white sage and just slide it into there. Like so. It's quite a nice looking little exhibit. Oh, they need food. Herp derp. I kind of have to put everything here at the start because I don't think my guy's going to be able to explore otherwise, but yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. We're not done. We're nearly done. Oh my god, I've got two more tundra animals to go after this. I forgot that. You know, I'm really glad we're deciding to, you know, take our time a little bit more with the animals and the design and everything like that in campaign mode as well. But it does slow things down. Now, there's a particular thing that I'm looking for. Oh, wait, tell you what, best way to do this. I'm going to look for education, which is already highlighted for some bizarre reason. I'm looking for a particular board style. Ah, it's that one there. That's what I want. That one right there. It's because the others are very African sort of inspired, which is, you know, very much what they're meant to be. Oopsie daisy. But I want one that's a little bit more neutral for the tundra zone, I think. And we need to stick on position snap. There we go. Locate that, put it over there. Nice. Okay. Plant-wise, do we go for the desert stuff or do we go for tundra stuff? That's the question. I think if we're going to have each exhibit be its own little microcosm with the snow, as in the snow doesn't... You hear me, game? So the snow doesn't progress past the boundaries, then I think we have to keep using the desert stuff in the actual... like, around the exhibit, basically. I think that's what we'll do. I really wish... Zoo Tycoon 2 did this, so it's a bit weird that this one doesn't, but you could do it so you could brush right to the edge of an exhibit, and like the brushing with your texture would stop at the barrier edge, basically. I don't know why it doesn't work on this. Okay, so we need some desert plants. Nature. So we're going continent, North America, biome, desert. I think that's it. I think that's all we're doing. Did we do anything else? It must have done, right? Well, it doesn't need to be North America desert in general. I was wondering where my proteas were. Put those along there. Again, just keeping that theming together a little bit, but we can do some other cool stuff that feels tundra themed. I'd like to build, I don't know who's going to live there, maybe the polar bears, but I'd like to build like an ice palace kind of thing. We have like these ice building blocks. It would be a shame not to use them, right? So I think like an ice palace for the polar bears is a pretty cool idea. I'm just gonna stick in some cacti and just decorate this whole area up a little bit. Joshua. Okay, even some desert rocks, go crazy with it. I'm a madman, what can I say? You know me, I love that noise. It's so I don't know, it's just so... Yeah, it's perfect. The sound design in this game is actually brilliant. It's not spoken of that often. Although I believe they did get like a reward for it or something fairly recently. Which is, it is genuinely one of the most underrated parts of the entire game. I pointed it out super early on, actually, like the first time we ever played the game on franchise mode. I saw the dev talk about someone else who talked about it as well. How when you go underwater or when you go inside the exhibit animal enclosure, it kind of like changes how the sound goes, you know, dulls all the sound and ups the echo sort of qualities. It's a really cool little detail. Crimson turkey bush, that's my favourite bush. Who doesn't love a crimson turkey? Oof. I have to be careful here. I don't want to clip that. Also, don't want this... I don't care. I was going to say, I don't want the edge of that to go into the exhibit, because they will actually complain about that, but I don't actually think it's a big deal. As long as they're moderately happy, which they are. This is one problem I have with the desert, in general. I can't do my usual... It's hard to do my usual foliage style, because the desert just would not have grasses popping up everywhere. It just wouldn't, right? Maybe in some bits. The desert is still more... Well, some deserts, anyway, are definitely more lifelike than people give them credit for, but... Generally speaking, I can't treat it the same way I treat everything else. But then again, it doesn't look like it needs it. The others do. The others kind of rely on it. I think the desert gets away with it. Yeah, you can still kind of go mental, if we're honest. You good there? Yeah, why not? I'd like a big tree in there. Okay, I'm feeling pretty good about this. Tundra Zone. You walk in, you ignore that, but you walk in, you look over here, and it's... It doesn't stick out as much as it could have, right? I don't know if I'm going to use the exact same glass ceiling for everything, because that might look a little... It's going to be too much repetition, but we can maybe bring in this wooden roof a little bit, and... I don't know, we'll come up with something. Oh, I want to do a path over the river. So the river, the path's going to come down here, and that's going to be another exhibit. Oh, it can happen over there as well. But that's going to be like a really nice little viewing point as well into that exhibit, so... Okay, yeah, I'm not sure whether to cover it with snow or not. Although I think putting down these plants means we've decided against that. Generally speaking, pretty happy with this. I think I want to block off this area a little bit more with some terrain, maybe some a wall across there a little bit. Definitely some plant life, but other than that, we are pretty good to go. So, next episode, what I might try to do... Let's take one more look here at our possible animals. I'm just wondering, can we bring in... a tundra animal that can live with the reindeer? And I'm not sure we can, because at the moment my other two tundra animals are going to be grizzly bears and arctic wolves, and I don't think they're going to live with the reindeer. It's actually a shame we did the doll sheep before, because we could have put the doll sheep with the reindeer. It would have saved a lot of space. What we could actually do is move the reindeer, or indeed the doll. Yeah, we can move the reindeer into here in theory. Because this exhibit doesn't scream reindeer by any extent, right? So we can move the reindeer into there, put the wolves in here, put the grizzly bears in here, and then do the other one over here somewhere, and then we just need to do the polar bears afterwards. We might do that. I'm not sure I've got the room to build three more big exhibits. There's my ghost reindeer, my favourite type of reindeer. But we'll have to wait and see. We'll end it there anyways. I'm pretty happy with how this looks. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Let's hit play for a moment and just... see our reindeer have a whale of a time. I also want to hire a keeper. I'm just going to work in the area. What's your name, son? Amos O'Donnell. That's a great name. And there we go. Reindeer. Cool. Reindeer? Hey, 98%, that's pretty good, and it's only that low because there's slightly too many plants, but also they haven't eaten high quality food. Yeah, cool. Happy reindeer. The ball's gone already. Don't knock the ball over. You're meant to use it to knock the blooming pins. Put that over there. Stay. No, stay. Okay, the ball just rolls of its own accord. Nope. No. No. Okay, I've got a plan. Okay. Reset. There we go! Set up nicely! Right! Yeah, I actually think this is a really cute little exhibit. Pretty happy how it looks. I think that top was the key to making this work. It really was. Yeah, feeling pretty good. So, let me know what you think in the comments down below. I am still tempted to bring... you know what, we'll just make two exhibits. I think next episode we'll just do a long one and we'll make a Arctic Wolf exhibit and a Grizzly Bear exhibit. In this kind of area, I'd like to bring some height or like a pit in some way, some depth and some height. So maybe you go over the bridge, over the river, and then it sinks into the ground, and there's like a wolf pit, and then a grizzly bear's over here, and then lots of room for the polar bear over there. And that would be our tundra zone. I like that idea. I think I like that idea. But let me know what you think. I will see you lovely folks in the next video. We happy? We're looking moderately happy. Where is everyone? You haven't escaped. Oh, wait, you have escaped. Oh, you're a reindeer. okay, we have some problems. I didn't think they could escape. Interesting. I should have checked, admittedly. It should have been the first thing I looked at. Yeah, just a little problem over here. Right, okay, that's easy to fix. All we need to do is grab a flatten, bring this down a little bit, and just... There we go. That shouldn't be a problem anymore. We good? However good. I kind of, yeah, that was, I brought that on myself. Okay, cool. Thank you for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.